what brought you to the center? And I know you flew from Utah for this. Why? How did you find Dr. Zaghi, and what interested you in this procedure?
I kept my cell phone next to my bed, and every time I woke up, I recorded the time, and I gave it to the doctor. They said, well, you have very mild sleep apnea from our sleep study, and no interventive measures are required. They told me I didn't really need anything, so I tried a CPAP machine, and once again, my sleep apnea was still pretty bad, and it didn't do anything. I never fell asleep even one time after using a CPAP machine for a week. So I returned it, and I told my brother, and I said, this is pretty bad. So I went to Dr. Zaghi. They were interns together. And Dr. Zaghi, I said, hey, I want a drug-induced sleep endoscopy. I did some research online and heard you can do this. And he said, okay, let me do some scope. And he saw my turbinates were very swollen. So he did some kind of turbinate reduction procedure. And I slept well for about 2 months until my throat started really getting bad. And I was waking up constantly. So then I talked to my brother again. I'm like, okay, this is really bad again. Now it's my throat. I only slept well for 2 months. And so I tried to find a way to get a drug-induced sleep endoscopy. I called a lot of hospitals. Most of them didn't even know what it was. They never heard of it. So finally, I was able to get here at Dr. Zaghi. I like can't stay awake at work. It's exhausting.
It's a sleep apnea, guys.
Sure it is, look at this.
What is that?
It is. Do you record it?
site of obstruction.
Wow.
Nasal pharyngeal. Maxillary. Try a jaw thrust with your hands. Just
how hard is it?
It's great that we're getting this information. Just do the jaw thrust.
You should do that again so
you
can film his face. Relax
the jaw.
I saw it a little bit.
Let's try the roll
recorded on my phone, I was waking up 40 times an hour, and they didn't believe me. They said the sleep study showed 13 times.
Yeah.
And I said, no, I am waking up 40 times. I have it on my phone every hour, every minute I was waking up. And they don't believe me. They're like, no, it's very not severe. It's very mild.
Yeah.
And I'm like, if I don't do the de-elevation, the mouthpiece,
yeah,
the temperature, the ibuprofen, I will have the worst sleep.
Yeah.
I'm falling asleep at work, I can't focus. It, like,
yeah,
it sucks.
We see it. We see how severe it is. So I think it's great that you came out here and you can allow us to do this and allow us to record it so that, you know, other people can learn and that, you know, you can figure out and show people what's going on, because it's pretty severe. I don't think anyone in this room will deny it. That what we saw was severe sleep apnea, without question. Doesn't matter what the papers show, that was severe sleep apnea that needs to be treated.
Yeah.
Okay?
So glad.
You're glad that you had it in a way?
No, I'm glad someone believed me.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
None of the doctors believe me. I'm like, this is severe.
No, I was just really impressed with the amount of sleep apnea that he had. As an anesthesiologist, we deal with sleep apnea all the time, and this was very different. It was very dramatic and unusual in a young person his body build.
Dr. Martin Gorman, and I'm a dental sleep medicine physician, and I was assisting Dr. Zaghi with the DISE procedure. In the fact, we had a upper and lower tray that is actually on a slide. So as the patient goes to sleep, we can slide his mandible forward and take care of any tongue-based issues that are involved with the sleep apnea. And at first, by sliding the jaw forward, it really had a huge impact on Austin's condition. But as you went into a deeper sleep, you realized that it was also a palate and a soft palate uvula issue blocking, and a pharyngeal issue blocking his airway. And dental oral appliances are mainly used for tongue-based issues. By sliding the mandible forward, the tongue comes forward, and it opens up the airway. But Austin had a dual issue, and he really had severe apneic events once he went into a deep sleep, and then the pharynx and the soft palate came in and took over, and it really made the dental appliance much, much less ineffective. So that's why I was assisting to see where the issue was, and what me and myself as a dentist could do to help Austin with his sleep apnea. And we can have a small impact on him, but the major impact really has to be dealt with from probably a medical surgical venue, and that's the only way you can probably be helped permanently.